Hello? Oh, hey, Queen. I'm in the theater. I can't really talk. Oh, except to say that he's really worried about being remembered for his art. That's his legacy, right?
Yeah, we really need to do what's best for him, I guess, so that his work is remembered.
Okay, well, I helped him organize his bio, and I sent his slides to Visual Aid, so at least he's in their archives. And Paul helped get that show organized at LaMama.
Oh, good.
But now Paul also wants to send his stuff to Art Basel Miami.
Oh, work. Well, you know how hot dead artists are.
Well, he's not dead yet.
Oh.
But we're really trying to get some collectors to donate something to a museum, like MoMA or PS1.
But there are no collectors. He's not in their collections now, and he's not a famous artist.
And those museums are also corrupt. They just show the work that's in their collectors' collections to pump up the value.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, that's why he wants to send everything to Art Basel Miami.
Yeah, I know. Well, if that's what he wants, I mean, hey, I mean... Hey!
Oh, hey!
Oh, my God.
That's silly.
That is silly.
Stupid.
I have an idea. What if we donated some of his work to his art school? Didn't he go to the Art Institute or something?
I don't know.
Ooh, I forget where he graduated from.
Yeah.
But if his work was in an institutional collection, he might be more well-known, and his work could inspire their kids, too.
True. Maybe. Actually, let's give his work away to his friends. Let's give it away to everyone so that they can surround themselves with it, so we can live with his art every day, just like he did. That's how he'll continue to inspire us. And who cares if he becomes a famous dead art star or not?
Who cares?
I mean, is it better to burn out or fade away?
What is
the etiquette of death?
Welcome to LaMama, Experimental Theater Club, dedicated to the playwright and all aspects of the theater. Tonight we are so pleased to present Chris Tanner's production of The Etiquette of Death. Now, Chris Tanner is one of my babies, and he has attracted such a wonderful group of artists on and off the stage. It is so overwhelming, and we are so honored that this is the last production of our 50th year anniversary. And because it's so warm today, I usually remember it, but I have to read it. Excuse me. Now, the director of The Etiquette of Death is the legendary Everett Quinton. Yes. He deserves all that, and he is co-starring it too. You'll be surprised. And assistant director is the vigilant Daniel Nelson. Choreography is by the celestial goddess Julie Atlas Muse. The assistant choreographer is the endlessly resourceful and energetic Jezebel Express. Costumes with the exquisite eye and taste is Becky Hubbard. Lighting by Let There Be Light, Susan Hamburger. Set designs by the attuned Stephen Hamill. Production manager is Leonie Eckinger, a beautiful young woman who has made over 1,000 notations in the computer about every word change, blocking, prop. Just thoroughly amazing. And our musical director, our conductor, our orchestrator, our contributing composer, he does so many things. I call him Mr. Music. But he has the choral director, the voice coach, and an actor on stage. And I'm going to ask him, have I forgotten anybody thus far?
Alan, that was perfect.
Oh, isn't he, darling? And you know, his sweetheart is... Oh, she was beautifully here last night. Dirty Martini. He's the very lucky man. They're at such a handsome cousin. Yes. Now, at our 10 minutes intermission, please peruse the program because it's the ensemble, the other playwrights, the contributing other composers and lyricists, and the band. And I know Jeremy has chosen all these artisans who are playing in the band who could be playing with the Metropolitan Opera, but too boring, and or the New York Symphony, or on Broadway 8 times a week. No, no. They prefer to be artistes downtown and do the survey of cutting-edge theater. Thank you, gentlemen. And a little birdie told me one of them is going with Lady Gaga. Now, I've talked about the intermission. Let's see. Oh, also available is a CD at the box office here in the lobby of some of the songs that you see in the show. So thank you so much for coming. Please enjoy the show. Have a wonderful summer, and we'll hope to see you in our 51st season in the fall. Bless you.
Go.
Aren't you kind? Well, now I have something very special. A dear friend of mine, direct from the land of Dixie, will entertain for you now the beautiful Bella Dubois. Put your hands together. Thank you.
Hey, y'all. You know how everybody's always up and down in the South? Well, some people, Yankees mostly, think that you could serve just about anything at a proper Southern funeral. Well, it just isn't true. You have to have the right everything. Oh, and being dead is no excuse. Hit it, fellas! Funerals in the South are steeped with tradition. There are two schools of thought about the food you should serve. Lots of fried chicken and homemade mayonnaise. Buying store-bought mayonnaise is considered absurd. The Methodists in general are better behaved, while the Episcopalians like to drink their pain away. Because in the South, funerals are a really big thing. And in the South, things are done a certain way. And in the South, deviation's not that big. Depending on what church you're from, you serve certain things. You're judged by the community, by the food that you bring. The Episcopalian ladies, they're very proper. They make homemade cheese straws and Coca-Cola cakes. They serve everything on their finest silver. And they'll drink several of the cocktails you make. When they hear that somebody's died, they're ready to throw a party in the blink of an eye. Because in the South, funerals are a really big thing, and you can't die without having certain things spread in the house. Stuffed eggs, sweet or savory, don't you dare call stuffed eggs devil. That's what Yankees say. Covered Pyrex dish. All of the ingredients are found in the cupboard. Campbell's cream soup, mushroom, nothing fresh. The food's so salty, not the best for your health. If you eat too much, your funeral might be the next. Because in the South, funeral food is what they make for me. Aspect, that sort of thing. In the South, serving hot tamales is taboo. You'll be thought of as tacky if you do. And proper Southern ladies just love to judge you. In the South, in the deep.
Gorgeous.
Why, Joan Girdler, you look so relaxed.
You too, darling.
Tell me, Palm Springs or Dr. Colfax?
Oh, I'll never tell. Ooh. So listen, I just would love to get the recipe for your fried chicken.
Well, Joan, I got it in my cookbook somewhere, but
Ooh. You know, I seem to forget it.
Oh, well, bring it next time.
Maybe next time I'll fry up a batch myself.
Oh, I love that.
But I gotta go, Joan. I got a man waiting for
me. Okay, well, get it going. Thank you. Isn't she lovely? So now, ladies and gentlemen, for the tip of the day. When you walk into a room, everyone should just die.
Pigeon standing on the air conditioner on the windowsill next to the front porch is dying, but still doesn't want to be hurt. Starts as though to fly away when I walk out the front door, but it can't fly. A dying pigeon can't fly anymore. It thinks I want to hurt it. I'll go back inside and leave it to the solitude of its last stand to fly into its thoughts alone.
This morning's coffee tastes so good, I hate to leave the pot. Its cordial fragrance fills the air, it's crisp and steaming hot. I wish that I could stick around till more of it was drunk. By golly, there's a donut left, I'd simply love to dunk. Farewell, dear company office, cause I've no more time to waste. But I'll regret for hours, hence my necessary haste. Good morning, darling. Did you sleep well? Did you have any dreams?
I dreamt I won the Academy Award for my masterpiece. And you were there. And you were wearing Balenciaga.
Balenciaga? What fun! Are you hungry? Has he eaten? Darling, would you like some kumquat? Or what about some chocolate chip pancakes with lots of vanilla ice cream?
No, Mommy, I think I'll start the day with an Austrian truffle.
You know, I'm not paying you to stand around. Why don't you go get him his breakfast?
Mommy's got calls to make. Work waits for no woman, and sometimes making the world a beautiful place is an ugly business. I love you.
Sure, I think I might be going mad. Well, that's something at least. At least my mind will find a hot new spot. Or not with the shattering of pain. I have become a plastic ghost. On the floor when you step on me, each time you throw me away. I crawl out of the trash can and bounce across the floor once more. But this feels different. Leave me there and step on me when the TV's out of order.
TV's out of order.
When your lovers and friends are out of town. Might be going mad. Well, that's something at least. But this feels different. This feels different. This feels different.
Hello, Poppy. This is Joan Girdler, your Etiquette Cosmetics regional sales manager. Well, how is that liver spot, dear? Well, are you using the effervescent emollient cream and the astringent that I told you to use? Well, every day and every night? Patience, dear, it takes time. Which reminds me, how are you? Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. Was she your only child? Well, have you thought about adopting? Well, what about getting a cat then? Well, take some Benadryl. The point is, Poppy, your sales are down and they need to go up, 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 and pronto, or else. Goodbye, dear.
I hear pigeons cooing.
Don't be ridiculous, darling. There's no pigeons here. We live in a respectable neighborhood. And you can take this goddamn Jean Harlow wig and walk! I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, darling. It's just, I've got this terrible headache. Yes, hello, this is Joan Girdler. Wonderful, thank you. Can I please speak to Millie? Darling, please drink your Ensure. Drink all of it. Hello, Millie, this is Joan Girdler, your Etiquette Cosmetics regional sales manager. Yes, thank you, dear. Well, I'm calling because your sales figures they've collapsed, dear. Well, couldn't you use crutches? What about a wheelchair, then? Well, how about a prosthesis? Millie, legs come and legs go, but etiquette is eternal. We're just going to have to let you go, dear. Goodbye.
I miss my sister.
Please do not mention that ungrateful child. Mommy's got a headache.
Probably living under a bridge somewhere.
Esmeralda, dear, how are you, darling?
Stoic.
Well, I don't know what that means exactly, but you wear it well. Are you using that bee pollen night cream I gave you?
Oh, it gives me a buzz.
Well, darling, you're not supposed to eat it.
Oh, I didn't know.
Well, darling, what do you think of my new foundation?
Takes off weeks.
Oh, you silly. Well, you know, high def. Well, I'm off to gild the lily. Yes, just a second. Hello? Oh, yes, this is she. I'm his mother. Oh, hi, doctor. Oh, his test results, you want us to come in? Well, can't you just give them to me over the phone? My plate is groaning. Well, yes, sir. Oh, all right. Yes, sir. I will bring him in tomorrow. Thank you. I'll make it happen. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Who was that?
A wrong number. Welcome, ladies, and all my loyal customers. This is Joan Girdler for Etiquette Cosmetics, where we color you beautiful. Thank you so much for joining me for this entire hour of advice and beauty tips on how to live the winning life. First tip of the day. If you're feeling low, put a brooch in the center of your chest and make sure that everyone in the room can see it sparkle.
My brooch! Where's my brooch? Get me my brooch!
I have it. It's right here. It's in my pussy.
And if you must go like this, go like this. And what does that inspire, ladies? Confidence! Who wants to be rich?
Why? Quiet, you bitches! I can't hear the television.
All rich people are in sales, and Etiquette Cosmetics is the perfect foundation for a wonderful sales career of any kind. And remember, ladies, you are missionaries. You are on a mission of beauty and hope. You bring out the goddess in every woman, and I salute you. Yes, and I honor you, and I honor our mission together. I will be hosting a very elite, very special spruntial bruncheon for my best ladies. Yes, 10 of my top ladies will luncheon with yours truly in the Turf Club at the world famous Santa Anita Racetrack. We will be kicking off our glamorously genius campaign, the title of which came to mean a daydream. Lavender, Allure, Illuminata.
Oh, I love it.
We will be dining on watercress sandwiches and chicken a la queen on toast points.
Yum, yum, need a muffin.
And I know how you all love fashion shows.
Oh, fashion.
I'm ready. Try it, you bitches. We'll all go.
And now, what you've all been waiting for. I, Joan Girdler, will read the 10 top ladies. First. Oh. Well, that must be my sayonara souvenir. Sayonara souvenir. That fragrance will save this. Oh, dear. Oh, Christy. Oh, are we a little cranky this morning? How did we sleep, darling? Oh, sweet daughter. Oh, no, please. That's your brother. Be nice to your brother. No, Christy. No, no, put it down. Oh, dear, please. Please. You love your brother. Oh, have you had any breakfast, sweetheart? Oh, darling. Oh, you know what I've always told you. A good hearty breakfast makes for a good sturdy thinker.
Or a good farty stinker.
Oh, you've got brown dirty everywhere. Oh, honey, mommy's got a little treat for you. Smell this. Isn't that good? Oh, come right this way. Oh, here, girl. Take this out of the house, you little bitch, and stay away. Darling, are you okay? Oh, it's all over everything.
I got nickels. I got dime bags. I got pussy. I got nickels, I got dime bags, I got pussy. Dirty purple birds shitting on the curb, chirping and burping and chewing worms. There's another flock shitting on the dock, chirping and burping and spreading germs.
Looking on the group, pooping on a stoop, hopping and dropping and turns along. There's another gaggle, watch a wiggle waggle, scooting and tooting a butthole song.
For you. You're just rats with wings. You do dirty things. Incest is the best in your pest infestedness.
Say, would you like to play on a rainy day?
No way, you're dirty purple birds, rotten purple birds, just filthy, dirty, rotten purple birds, and you smell like turds!
Doctor?
Thanks for coming on such short notice.
Oh, that's all right.
Well, you see, I got your test results back today and wanted to see you right away because they're positive.
Oh, good.
No. Positive is not good. Joan, you have brain cancer.
Oh, doctor.
Really?
You've lost weight.
Yes, I have a stomach parasite. But listen, Joan, the brain cancer is in stage 4, which means... There's really nothing else I can do for you. I'm sorry.
Well, the check's in the mail.
Well, that's good. I'll call you about Joey.
Oh, all right. Okay, thank you. And don't slouch.
Yes, of course.
Never explain, never complain. Even if your life is circling the drain and your skin's falling off and you're going insane, suck it up, don't explain. Keep things up, don't complain. Take a deep, slow breath, put a hummingbird here, holds you up into the air. Flutter, 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 flutter. Spread your wings. Flutter, 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 flutter. Now glide across the floor with your sternum floating up, your head upon your spine, your shoulders down. Never stutter.
Local Grave Diggers Union. Let's get the kids.
Mommy, I don't want to die.
I got it. In the early 80s, friends started to get sick and die from AIDS. We wanted to help, so we became caregivers. While taking a crash course on doctors, hospitals, clinics, medicine, funeral parlors, burials, or cremations. We walked under a cloud of death for years. Finally, in the mid-90s, it subsided due to new drugs. Now other friends had other ailments. You name it, they had it. Some succumbed to heart attacks, strokes, cancer, and old age. At this point of our lives, we all had a very large collection of memorial or holy cards, leaflets or programs from celebrations, announcement letters with photographs, mementos, snapshots, and blessed memories. And a still growing folder of obituaries. I am not afraid to die. No, Because I believe when the soul leaves the body, it ascends to heaven and joins all our loved ones who have gone ahead to paradise. Yes, I do think about thinning out my possessions so my friends will have less to deal with. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. The clock is always running, and you'll never know how, when, or where. Oh, death is so democratic. She's going to visit everyone someday.
How did you get in here? Security as well as... Oh, my God.
It's her.
Is it really you? I'm your biggest fan. Oh, you're my favorite TV host. We watch your show all the time.
All the time.
Hell are you? I'm a travel agent of sorts. I'm planning a little trip for your son.
Hey, well, this is not the best of times.
The timing's out of your control.
You look like death warmed over.
Thanks. I work at it.
But you've got the most marvelous bone structure. Oh, yes, very stately. You're a classic beauty. Your face could be on a coin or on the dollar bill.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. Maybe on a tombstone. Listen, sister, I don't have time for this. Death waits for no one. Get him, bitches.
Wait! Etiquette Cosmetics could even make you drop dead gorgeous. I'm going to color you beautiful. I'm going to make you the most glamorous woman in all the world.
I'd like to see that.
Then I could go to a funeral parlor and pick up a man.
But Your Majesty, you are dead.
And everybody hates you.
Despises you.
Loathes you.
She is trying to trick you.
So you allow her son to live.
Oh, you're just jealous of my most marvelous bone structure.
Your Majesty, everybody fears you.
The fear that energizes you.
Without the fear, you're nothing. You're dead.
She's trying to kill you.
To destroy death.
Is that what you want?
No, that's not true. They're just little liars. As a matter of fact, I'm looking for a new co-host. And next to me, you're the biggest celebrity I know. I'm going to make you a huge star. You can help me launch my new campaign, Etiquette for the Dead. All the morticians all over the world will be killing each other to get their hands on this product. We will corner the market. I will make you a gazillionaire.
Fear and money, my two favorite desserts.
Look, she's lying to you.
Let's grab her son and get the fuck out of here.
Quiet, bitches! You've appealed to my greed, Joan Girdler. I love greed. It destroys empires, creates slaves, topples countries. Darlings, you've got yourself a deal, Joan Girdler. Shake hands with death. Your new co-host. Now, make me over.
Where's my midnight rendezvous kiss me now mask?
Oh, the midnight rendezvous kiss me now mask. Oh, what fun. This is more fun than an autopsy.
Here it is.
Oh. And just in case you're thinking of tricking me, Joan Girdler, let me give you a taste of my power.
Taste of brownie again.
What's a brownie?
What? You ain't ever had a brownie before? Jeez Louise. That's a good thing you're so hunky. Else I'd have to, kill you.
Go on. Torture me.
Well, it's kind of like a chocolate cake, right?
Uh-huh.
Soft and gooey on the inside.
Uh-huh.
With a crusty, toasty layer on the out. Sometimes, sometimes they put nuts in it.
Uh-huh.
And then you bite into it.
Oh.
And there's this incredible mix of flavors and textures bursting in your mouth. Soft and crunchy. Oozing with chocolate and fudge. Yeah, can't wait.
That's a German cake. I've had it in Dusseldorf.
No, it ain't. Ain't fucking German. Shit's American. I mean, my mom's makes it for me. I mean, it's from a recipe book by a woman called Fanny Farmer.
Hey, it's German, no question about it. That fudge-oozing chocolate bit pinned it down for me.
Yeah, well, that was before the war then. It's American now. I mean, it's as American as apple pie.
Your mom is very good at making things.
So is yours.
You wanna play war, Scarecrow? Like I always say, death, it's the great equalizer. You haven't lived till you die.
I have never really been afraid of dying.
What I was afraid of was not living.
Being afraid to act on my life was the thing that scared me.
I'm getting sick. Yeah, I'm afraid of it.
Being murdered?
Yeah, makes me scared.
Having an awful accident.
Horrible. But the dying part and the staying dead part has never scared me.
Yeah, even when I was a kid, I seemed to understand early that death was going to come when it came.
And from what I can understand, even when I was very young, was that there was no stopping death.
Not once it came for you.
When I was little, the only bad thing I knew that could happen to you was death.
I didn't know about betrayal.
Or self-loathing.
Or morbid fear.
Or emotional paralysis.
Yet.
The first person I knew who died was my godmother Philomena's daughter, Millie.
Millie
looked young.
And wore pedal pushers.
And men's white shirts.
Open.
At the throat.
She chain smoked.
Oh, and no other woman I knew even smoked.
Oh, and fun. And there was something so rebellious about her, too. Millie was in her early 40s. Her kids were grown up and married.
Yeah, but Millie was small.
And skinny.
And Jew.
She had short, dark hair cut in what we used to call a pixie. Oh, yeah, and she reminded me of those pictures I'd seen of
Judy Garland. If I'm honest about it, and I admit I don't know how to explain this to you, but I used to think of Millie as Judy Garland.
Or as some kind of extension of Judy Garland.
As if Judy Garland was this house. And Millie was a room in that house.
Millie got sick right after the Vatican unsainted St. Philomena.
Who Aunt Philomena was named after.
Believe me, that was a trauma.
Not just for Aunt Philomena, but for everybody.
As if Aunt Philomena herself was invalid in some important way.
And then Millie got sick.
I guess Millie had cancer.
And everybody whispered
she was dying. She wasn't in the room. And when she was in the room, she didn't say anything at all.
I think she knew.
That's a dead giveaway.
Well, total death, total silence goes with death.
Yes!
Isis! Isis!
If you kiss me now, mask is killing me. My face is on fire. What's in this shit?
We read the directions, I promise.
What did you read it in? Pidgin English, you stupid bitches?
Well, we don't know how to do it.
Really?
Help me stop the pain.
Well, you still trust that etiquette lady, Joan Girdler?
Let's get Joan Girdler, the big fat liar. Isis, sister, come! My face! It's on fire!
No matter what you say, no matter where you
boy.
I don't have fatal intentions here. Not yet. My face, it's on fire. Help me make the pain stop.
Okay. Yeah. Well, let the makeover begin. Here, come with me. Get in that chair. Okay. Well, what sort of look are you thinking of? How do you see yourself?
I want to be Audrey Hepburn, cute lady. Make me pretty.
All right.
And if I like what I see, I'll give your son a little more time. So...
hurry up. Get those creams flowing. Tweeze me, scour me. I want my skin glowing. Tighten me up, firm up the jowls. I wanna be as adorable.
Get a good look at you. Oh. Ooh. Makeup, makeup. Oh, nothing. Applicators, applicators, applicators. Oh, it's not working. It's not working. I forgot the rhythmic padding to the skin to bring the blood to the surface. Are we ready?
You're just doing this on purpose.
No.
You're trying to trick me.
No.
Don't let your son live. Get in, bitches.
No, please. Wait, it's not natural for a boy to go before his mother. Please, it takes time and patience. Transylvania wasn't built in a day. I've got one more brilliant idea.
Let me see what you got.
Take this secret formula. Here, and put this mask on. It must not be removed for 3 days under any circumstances.
3 days?
Yes.
3 days? Yeah! All right. 3 days. And not a second longer. The clock is ticking. Bitches, let him live.
Oh, thank you.
For now.
Three days. Gather yourself around yourself. If I can control my etiquette empire, I can handle this.
You sure can, Joan!
Lost is a trail of fools behind her. She'll lead you blind if you try to find her. Lost for a moment and you'll cry if only. You best be careful what you say. Stand away, no other way for it to be. In the wind, hear the crawl behind you. Start to wonder what on earth will find you. You made a deal with a lady, and may I remind you, you best be careful what you say. Stand away, no other way for it to be. Stand away, no other way for it to be. You must be careful what you say. Their way to being, or that make believe.
fall prey to fear. They get confused, fight as they might to break the rules. And she veiled in the night with endless eyes and appetite for finding fools with whom to play. For finding fools, she has a way.
In her grasp, it's so familiar. How many fools will it take to fill her? You made a deal with a lady and you're pleased to thrill her. You best be careful what you say. Stand away, no other way for it to be. Stand away, no other way for it to be.
Hello. One moment, please. It's for you, Joan Girdler.
Hello, Joan.
Yeah?
Joan, it's Dr. Jennings again.
Hello?
Hi. Listen, Joan, I was just checking in to see if you need any painkillers or anything. And by the way, we really have to talk about palliative care for Joey. I mean, I think we should take him to the hospice right now.
Wrong number! You liar! I hate you! I hate your passion-faced wife! And your wall-eyed kid! I hope they all die! In a horrible car accident! I'm plunging a dagger right in your throat! I'm pitching a knife at your eye! I'm putting a banana peel under your heel! You're a liar! You lie! Now die!
when Daddy died.
Where were you when Baby died?
Where were you when Brother died?
Where were you when Sister died?
Where were you when Grandpa died? Oh,
where were you when Grandma died?
Where were you when Nephew died?
Where were you when Cousin died?
Where were you when Auntie died?
Where were you when Uncle died?
Where were you? The Flamingo Hotel? I was at home with blood on my hands.
I was at home with shit on my hands.
But where did it go?
It just went up the sky.
But where did it go?
It just went up in smoke.
But where did it go?
It just went up in flames.
I was at home waiting for you.
Well, I was at home, and you never came.
Sounds hungry.
He's not hungry, Bella. He's
I have some soup on the stove. Minestrone. It's his favorite.
He hasn't eaten in 3 days.
Well, no wonder he's hungry.
I'd like to just... She's a hot mess.
Who can blame her? Married 40 years, it's hard to let go.
I can blame her. I have been sitting in this dreary, stuffy... smelly apartment for 5 days. I have had it.
You were his favorite sister.
Well, of course I was his favorite. I was clever and pretty.
And I wasn't.
Oh, how I loathe rhetorical questions. I think it's time to call her.
We can't do that to Bella.
I have opera tickets. I'm calling.
It's almost ready. I'll let him taste it. It'll make him feel better.
Oh, I can hardly wait to see his tap routine.
You know, dear, I think maybe, well, How can I say this gently? I think he's past the point
Stop
of...
Stop it! He never left you to one of you!
I'm sorry, I'll take that back. He did like you.
I did it!
Oh, she is living in Cloud Cuckoo Land.
It's a difficult river to cross.
Oh, well, you call it with the cliches. Oh, excuse me, I lost my jewelry. Thank you.
You know, Evelyn, that's not all you've lost. And someday you're going to die, too.
Oh! I look forward to the change in scenery. And could you keep it down in there? I'm trying to make a call.
You're going to kill her with this.
Ooh, a twofer. I just love a bargain. Hello. This is Evelyn. What? How am I? Well, I'm exhausted and I'm bored and I'm... What? Oh, no, darling, I'm not calling about me. I'm calling about it. Can you come over? Now!
Who are you talking to?
Oh, I was just booking a mani-pedi.
I hope you weren't calling her.
She was ordering Chinese.
Yes.
Mushu pork. Yes. We have to keep her strength up.
Well, did you order Fred's Mugu Gapan?
Oh, he can have my fortune cookie.
You're both lying to me.
Oh, you're lying to yourself.
What's that, dear? You need more salt. And another 5 minutes. I'll set the timer.
Oh, dear, this is going to be ugly and sad.
And over.
Somebody rang.
Well, where's the Mugu? You can't go in there. No!
Get her up.
In dancing, cooking, and learning to sing, it's not limb or lamb, a voice that's king.
Your best. But for the rest,
it's timing that's really everything. So if you want to boost your stock, don't waste a dime on hair and frock.
Avoid disgrace and know your place.
Keep your eye on the goddamn clock.
Know when it's time to liquidate. Better leave early than stay late.
Don't be deposed.
Time for a little break. Why don't you all take 10? See you soon.
I go by many names. I have many faces and many facets. And all rivers find their way to me. Each drop of rain and every tear shed in sorrow or delight. The slime from every sewer and anything that you try to hide in my dimension materialize. They are the jewels that I find. And it matters not to me if they are the jewels from your darkest moments or the gleaming bits from your most triumphant hour. All your moves make jewels for me.
Another drink, please.
Did you hear Emerald von Steiner died?
No.
Gangrene?
No.
Yeah, he was taking a walk out in the woods to escape the sickness in his home. His lover, 26 years his senior, closing in on death, convalescent, sucking the life out of Emerald. Oh, ringing his bells, calling out at night, soiling the sheets, melting into sag, a lump of sag, like molded bread, his lover's skin. And the smells, oh, spores and filtering, decimating him. He knew he was next. He knew the infection. Oh, thank you. He knew the infectious disease called old age was out to get him. His lover, oh, that lover. He would pass it on to him, and it would corrode his insides slowly, though. Emerald had spent the last 15 years of his life watching his lover decay. It had become his job. Once he made things, he was a bright, shiny maker. Now he shoveled sheets, medicines. Are you all right? Hello? Hey. As I was saying, he shoveled sheets, medicines, schedules, and a performing comfort. He knew how long it would take, and his time came, he thought, well, he'd speed that along. He, too, was a smart man. He knew that death was no great marker of intellectualism.
You know, everybody was smart enough to die, except Walt Disney.
Asshole. Unlike others, he was smart enough to know that death was a piece of cake, but dying was the problem. He resolved to tackle the problem later. Now was his time to school. He left the house. He left the house. Time to stroll. He left the smells, the schedules, and nouns to collect that. It was a beautiful winter's day, not beauty from clear skies or crisp white snow, though that too, but beauty from freedom, being out in the world, doing something completely unconnected with the care of things. His nose hairs crackled as he breathed, the cold of the light invigorating. He decided to step with one foot onto a sheet of ice to see if it was sturdy enough. Mm. It was. Ooh. Would it hold his full weight? All right. It was. He would continue walking on top of the stream, taking care not to slip. Always aware that at any minute he could fall through to the numbing water below. It was fun to add a little danger into his life. Not too much, just enough to feel something other than duty for a little while. Hey, my God. What the hell? Oh, whoa. Never mix, never worry. It's not tonight. Where was I? Oh, yeah. So he was in no danger of falling through the water. In fact, the stream was just a stream. It's about 4 inches deep. I mean, at worst, his feet will get wet. It'll be long. You're from a good family. At worst, his feet would get wet. I mean, he'd be uncomfortable. He'd have to go back to the house. That was the true danger. Going back to the weight of nouns. No. 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 Not before he was ready. The ice cracked. but did not break through. His heart beating faster brought a smile to his face. Laughter bubble, not the kind of laughter they got in accustomed to. Now, this was laughter from participating in the world, risking humiliation by nature, being the lead in a being the lead in the prep hall rather than an observer. He strolled on, up the street, grabbing at frozen branches to help him through slopes and slippery surfaces, risking hand-free glides, pretending to be a ballerina. But the windows would have blown. He slipped. Oh, he caught his mouth. He laughed. Tears tempted a freeze on the side of his cheeks. He continued his perilous journey. He just about made it to the source of the stream when a sunny patch of light, his foot pressed through the ice to the free waters below. He yanked it out as quickly as possible, and on the way, the side of his cap was cut to his pant leg long underwear by a shard of ice. His foot wasn't even soaked. It was a little damp. I mean, the waterproof boot had done its job. Well, he thought, with the diminished spirit of one who dreams of surviving a humiliation, but it fails. Oh, my God. Christ, not again. We're in the social register. Anyway, where was I? Oh, yeah. I mean, the cut wasn't even deep. I mean, it just bled a little bit, and in the cold, you could hardly feel the sting of it, though the weight of it turned his throwing to a drudge. I mean, oh, the joy of his adventure slipping and falling behind him on his uphill climb home. Once he got to the house, took off his boots, looked at the cut, cleaned it. Maybe not as good as he should have. He went about 10 to the other now. That night his lover died. 2 days later, Emerald died of gangrene.
Oh, that's terrible.
There's the breaks. I gotta go to the powder room.
Let's go.
All right.
I'll help you. Come, darling. Not bad. You have to take that?
Yes.
Come, darling. Here we go. Here we go.
My poison is your poison, stupid ones.
My poison is your poison, stupid ones. You slurp up nectar like greedy bees. But tomorrow or next decade, you'll bleed, you'll rot.
Medicine's gonna kill me before the cancer does. So tired all the time. Remember when work used to be so easy and so fun?
Please. Yes, please.
Here we go.
Did you hear Carl Conrad?
No.
Mm-hmm. Heart attack.
At his age?
He was 40.
Wasn't that young?
No, enough.
Well, it's young, too.
Old enough not to exaggerate the surprise.
Oh, I don't think that's true.
Listen. At 40, you've been out of here. You've been given enough time to find out who you are. And if you haven't done so, if you squandered your time, then you haven't earned the surprise of others when you die.
Is that what he did?
No. He had found himself. He knew who he was, but he wasn't always happy with that person.
No.
Yeah. Mm. Oh. Not good. Now, listen. Here's in the kitchen.
Yep.
Making a pot of peppermint tea for his eggs.
Ugh. His eggs?
Eggs.
Oh.
Eggs. He's having eggs. Anyway, he was wrapping the cozy around the teapot, thinking about a tweet he sent out.
Can I have a spoon?
Can the lady have a spoon, please? I tell you, this restaurant's going downhill. Anyway, he was thinking about a tweet he sent out. Regretting it.
Oh.
I mean, he seemed bombastic. Did he always have to be the center of the debate? Couldn't she listen? Ooh. I have some charity work I gotta do.
You wanna go?
Yes. Check, please.
I didn't finish.
All right, take it to go. All right.
Well, wait for me. I'll come and get you.
Right.
Come on, honey. Come on. Come, darling, let's blow this joint. Here we go. Okay, here we go, my darling. Okay.
There's no escape. better for seeing you, sweetie. Well, here we are in the Turf Club at the world famous Santa Anita racetrack. And what about that horse meat tartare? Wasn't it divine? Giddy up. Hi, Mitzi. I love that hat. Well, let's begin. Ladies, your eyes are the window to your soul. And with our lovely, lush mascara, you'll have the prettiest curtains. Peek-a-boo. Oh, and here comes our purple passion lipstick. Remember, ladies, to always smile. It's the second most important thing you can do with your mouth. Naughty, naughty. Men love a woman that smells like petals after a spring rain. And ladies, you'll love our moist petals perfume. And so will the men in your bush. I mean, your life. Cars should be shiny. Noses not. And with our new Rush Crush Compact, your nose will be shine free and ready to snort up a freshly crushed Dexy. Just kidding. Well, sort of. Maybe not. Whoops. She's a girl living the life with a luminata. She is a pearl lounging in an oyster.
Should just die. I want to thank you, Joan Girdler, for my lovely new looks and for making me so cute.
Oh, you're repulsive! Shit. I should have tried a test patch.
I want to fuck you in your hole where your soul used to be before I ate it. Into a room, everybody will die. Everyone but you, Joan Girdler. One day you'll die, and you'll die lonely, having immolated all your friends to idle anecdotes. It will be cancer, and you will have asked for it. All those years of almost living truthfully, but never being able to fully embrace the truth, will catch up with you, eat you, grow. You will be afraid to go alone to your chemo. Friends who pretend to be friends will go with you so they can tell others what good friends they are. You'll thank them, expect a call, a follow-up, but it won't come. Not for a week. They'll have forgotten all about it. Too many things to do. And you'll sit by the toilet, vomiting, knowing no one truly cares. You'll know that the world has left you behind. You'll know that you are finished. You will hope the end will come quick, but it won't. It will hurt. Days and weeks and months of hurting and the weight of other people's obligations. wishes will descend. People whose names you can't grasp. You'll ask them to lie in bed with you to share some time. They'll make jokes. They'll cry. And they'll be done with you already. They'll be looking for the exit. And you'll die surrounded by a house full of strangers, orange plastic medicine bottles, and the stink of yesterday's vomit stuck to your teeth. Where are my pigeons?
No, Christine! No!
Kill that woman!
No!
Get back!
What's the big fucking deal anyway? I'm not afraid of death. Life sucks anyway. You eat shit and then you live without a toothbrush.
No, Chrissy! Put down that gun! Now! No, Chrissy! Put down that knife! Now! No, Chrissy! Not the pearls! No.
Just pull on them. Put them. Just pull. Yank them. Yank them. Yank them.
Christy. Christy. Mommy. Oh, I feel terrible.
A little further.
Can't you do something to make me look a little prettier?
You look so good.
What you see are your fears, Joan Girdler. Death is what gives life its meaning. Death is the grand finale. Without death, life would lose its poetry.
Open your mouth.
Oh, what a good boy. Yeah.
Open it. Oh, no. No. Oh, what a pretty boy.
Yes. Yes. Time for me to go now.
Oh, sweet.
Of a priest and the rectum.
All right, Joan, no crying. It's time to go.
Well, can I just fix my mascara?
Nope. I've got another appointment.
Well, anybody I know? Anybody famous?
It's sort of a group excursion, if you know what I mean.
Oh, an airplane?
Shh.
Well, what's next?
There's nothing next.
Well, what about an afterlife?
Honey, you're born, there's your life, and then there's me. That's it.
Are you sure?
Well, I've never heard back from any of my clients. What a bunch of whiners. You know, so many people have truly beautiful lives. But by the time they get to me, they can't see that anymore. Which is why so few have truly beautiful deaths. I mean, I try to make it nice for them. But they're all into the grotesque Halloween pain of it all. Maybe it is my face that scares them. I should kill you twice for that. Oh. Now, come on, sweetie. We're running out of time, and so are you. Get in the boat.
Would you work for God?
Get in the boat.
Well, you're not in contact with God or the devil. What about Buddha?
They're both human inventions. Come on, sister. I got a huge transfer of souls in Africa in 10 minutes, and I don't want to get back to... Look, get in the goddamn boat, or you will be liquidated on the spot. No boat ride.
Listen, why don't we just trade jobs? You can get rid of this death trip. I'll take your job, and we haven't even finished your makeover yet.
I look deader than Ethel Merman in Gypsy. I should have known that death can never take a holiday. Oh, get a makeover. Oh, come on. You gotta sing a traditional song and get in the boat.
What song?
Well, didn't that angel intern I sent teach it to you?
No, he just wanted a makeup lesson.
All right. I'll teach it to you. It makes the passing easier.
Well, what are we doing?
We are dying. You're dying. Well, I die a little bit each time I take someone. But I never get to die completely. Something always yanks me back at the end. Mortis interruptus. It's so frustrating. Come on. 1, 2, 3. Baby cried the day the circus came to town.
Oh, I gotta sing that crappy cabaret song before I die?
As you die.
But isn't that a Shirley Bassey number?
No.
Isn't she dead yet?
I've been working on this song for hundreds of years, and it always does the trick. Now, get in the boat, or you might sink it.
No, I don't want to drown like those Titanic people.
Oh, my God, those people were the worst. I was up all night with them, and not one of them wanted to sing the song. They were too cold. And by the way, your son did a beautiful job with the song.
Oh, thank you.
Lifted me up. Precious. I bet he gets a singing gig in his next life.
Next life? You never said there was a next life.
Oh, honey, everyone gets seconds, thirds, hundreds of chances. Old lamps for new. There's that little angel now. Where have you been? Oh, don't tell me.
I've never done this before.
Oh, for God's sake, come on, I'll teach it to you.
No, how does it go? It's the baby
cried the day the circus came to town.
But she didn't want bridges passing by her. So she came on a smile, took a whistle to town. And they danced without a net upon a wire.
In this song. Is it, am I getting near? Is it working?
It's killing me. I know that thought of that is caught you to me.
Babies.
Put this on.
Not like me.
Gently. Sit on her face.
Don't cry out loud.
Is she done then?
She's a tricky one. I don't want to have to deal with a ghost later on. They're so hard to re-extinguish.
Why did you tell her all that stuff about other lives? You know there aren't any.
Just stay on it till she's gone. Keep singing.
I'll never stop singing. Sing along with us, and we love you. Thanks for coming.